the coronavirus pandemic and geopolitical tensions. These are among reasons why the Duterte administration suspended the termination of the visiting forces agreement with the United States.
World leader must be quick in mind and fast on his feet for the safety of our nation and the peace of the world.
The suspension will be in effect for 6 months and can be extended by President Rodrigo Duterte for 2 more quarters. Philippine Defense Secretary Delfin Lorenzana supports the move, saying his agency is ready to work closely with U.S. counterparts to address common concerns, such as the COVID-19 crisis. The development comes as the Supreme Court gave the Executive Secretary and the Foreign Affairs Department 10 days to comment on a petition filed by the Senate seeking to clarify its role in treaty abrogations. Duterte originally scrapped the VFA in February, on the heels of America's decision to cancel the visa of his ally, Senator Ronald De La Rosa. The lawmaker was formerly Duterte's national police chief, who implemented the president's anti-drug war. The visa cancellation followed efforts by several U.S. lawmakers to ban Philippine officials, allegedly behind the detention of Filipino opposition Senator Leila De Lima. For De La Rosa, who has not yet applied for a new U.S. visa, the suspension of the termination is a welcome development. Senate Minority Leader Franklin Rilon and Senator Panfilo Lacson are also happy with the news. They believe the Philippines will benefit from the VFA amid Chinese intrusions in the West Philippine Sea. A security analyst echoes similar sentiments.
And of course, deception right now that in the light of the pandemic, China is basically becoming more assertive, not only in the South China Sea, in the Taiwan Straits, in the East China Sea, and elsewhere, China flexing its muscle.
Philippine Ambassador to the U.S. Jose Manuel Romualde says discussions with U.S. Ambassador to Manila Song Kim are underway on ironing out the suspension.
In the future, I foresee, perhaps not during the administration of President Duterte, but down the road, there will be some form of agreement that will, or a mechanism that will be able to help in making sure that we have this mutual defense treaty in place and be able to be implemented.
Washington also welcomes the Philippine government's change of heart. It says the long-standing alliance has benefited both countries and hopes that it will continue in the future. Willard Cheng, ABS-CBN News.